Hello, and welcome to this on-demand webinar from Text Help with me, Dean Stokes. I spend my time visiting schools all around the world to show them how to get the most out of G Suite for Education. In this series, I'm going to show you how to start using Google Classroom. This first session will cover the basics of creating and setting an assignment, and then we'll move on to some more advanced features through the series. I'll be checking the comments, so if you do have any questions about anything I cover, just leave them below the video. Now, this session is designed for beginners who are maybe new to G Suite for Education or Google Classroom, or for users that have been using Google Mail or Drive for a while and want to start using Google Classroom. It's also great if you'd like a refresher, or if you'd like to find out more about Text Help's read and write for Google Chrome. So you need absolutely no prior knowledge to follow this webinar, though you do need a G Suite for Education account. I recommend pausing the webinar at key points as you follow along for the best experience. So let's get started. Now the first thing you need to do is head to the Google homepage, and if you're not already, click the blue button in the top right to sign in. Now once you're logged in, you need to head over to Google Classroom. I think the best way to do that is to click inside the Omni box and just type classroom.google.com. Now, if this is the first time you've used Classroom, you're probably going to get this prompt. It's asking if you're a student or teacher, so just click the Teacher button. And if any of your students get to this screen and say that they're a teacher, it's not a problem, just speak to your administrator and they can change their permissions back to being a student. Now, if you want to get to Classroom easily next time, you might want to bookmark the page. And to do that, we just click this star on the right-hand side of the Omnibox, change the title if you'd like, and then click Finished. Now that bookmark will appear on the bookmarks bar, but if your screen looks like mine and doesn't show the bookmarks bar just yet, we need to enable it. Just click on the menu button on the right hand side, then scroll down to Bookmarks, and then choose Show Bookmarks Bar. And there you go, there's an easy link to get to Classroom anytime you need it. So if you've never used Google Classroom before, this is the screen that you come to the very first time. If you have created classes in the past, you might see them in a list here. Right now though, we need to create our first classroom. So we're going to click on the plus button at the top right of the screen here, and then choose Create Class. Now it's asking here for three pieces of information. You only need to add a class name, but you can also add a section or a subject if that would be helpful. Now I'm just going to call my class Dean's Class, but you might put your class code from your timetable here, for example. And once you've done that, just click Create. So once you've created a class, it takes you to what's called the class stream. And the stream is where all the magic happens. That's where all of your assignments and announcements and questions are going to appear. Now don't worry about what those different things are. We're going to find out much more about them as we work through this series of four webinars. So that's great, you've created your first class. Now before we set an assignment in Classroom, we need to create a resource that we're going to set as part of the assignment. And to do that, we're going to head over to Google Drive. So all you need to do is click on the New Tab button at the top of the screen here, then click on this Apps Launcher button on the right-hand side and choose Drive. Now this might already be familiar if you've used Google Drive before, but if you haven't, don't worry, it's nothing scary. Google Drive is just like another folder on your computer, except everything is stored in the cloud. Now you can see here that Google Classroom has created its own folder called Classroom. Now you don't really need to worry about this folder, but what's inside here is another folder for each class, and inside the class folders is a folder for each assignment, which contains all of the student work for that assignment. In this webinar, we're going to create a Google Doc which students will complete next time. So to create a document, we click on the New button on the top left, and then choose Google Docs. Now that opens a new tab with a blank document, and this should all be quite familiar if you've ever used Word or PowerPoint. Today, we're just going to create a simple poetry worksheet, so I'm just going to add a title to my document now. Now it's up to you whether you use the same example or something that maybe you already have. Now a quick tip, to stay organized, it pays to name every document. Otherwise, we just have a whole list of untitled documents. So in Google Docs, once you've typed something into the document, you can then go and click where it says Untitled Document, and it will automatically use the text that already appears there. So I'm just going to add Task 1 here, and I'm going to say fill in the blanks of the poem. I've got a poem from the internet here, and I've taken some of the words out, and they're going to have to fill in the blanks. And I'm just going to quickly format this document as well so that it's really clear where the title is and where the task is. And I'm going to change the color of these question marks so that they stand out nice and clearly for the students as well. I'm going to add a second task, and that task is going to say, use the Explore tool to find a relevant image. Now, as this webinar series goes on, we're going to learn about lots of innovative different ways to set tasks for students using Google tools. This is just a very simple example to get you started. Now that we've got a piece of work, we're going to head back over to Classroom by clicking the tab at the top of the screen here. But before we set an assignment, we need to make sure we have some students to complete it. Adding students to Classroom is really easy. All we need to do is click the Students tab here. And you see on this Students tab, it gives us a code. We simply share this code with the students at the beginning of our first lesson. Here's what it looks like for them. They click on the plus button and type in the code. And you see now they have a very similar view to you. Great, so now that we've added the students, we can get to work on setting an assignment. Now, anything you need to post in Google Classroom lives under this one button in the bottom right. And it really doesn't get any easier than remembering one button. There are a few options here, and by the end of the series, you would have used them all. But for now, we're going to choose Create Assignment. Now, this prompt is asking for all of the details. We just need to put in a title. So I'm just going to call this Poetry Activity. And if you want to, you can leave some more detailed instructions here. Here you can set a due date. You can also leave a topic here, which is really helpful for finding all of the assignments under one topic in future. And you can see here on an assignment, I can do a number of things. I can attach a file from my computer, any kind of file. I can choose something from Google Drive. I can link to a YouTube video, or I can link to somewhere else on the internet. All of those things can be really helpful to give the students the resources they need. For now, we're going to choose a file from Google Drive, and we're going to select the poetry worksheet we created earlier, and then click Add. Now, once we've done that, over on the right-hand side here, we get a few different options. The first says students can view file. That means they'll all have access just to look at it. The second option says students can edit the file, and that means that all of the students will be able to collaborate on this one file. But this time, we're going to use one of the most powerful features in Classroom. We're going to ask Classroom to create a copy for each student. Now down here next to the Assign button, I can actually choose to schedule this post. So if you want to be super organized, you could sit down on the first day of the week and set all of your assignments so that they appear at the right time for each class. But I'm just going to click Assign. Once we've clicked Assign, we can see the assignment appears in the stream. And over here, it tells us that two students are yet to complete this piece of work. Now, from a student's point of view, it looks very similar. Here's the assignment in their stream. They just click Open, and it shows them the file, and we can see there that it has their name on it. It's their own copy. Aside from posting assignments, you might also want to post an announcement. An announcement is a simple message, maybe to let students know that you're not going to be in the lesson today, or to remind them to bring in their PE kit or their ingredients for something they're making. To post an announcement, just like before, we mouse over the button in the bottom right of the screen, but this time we choose Create Announcement. So it's a really similar screen as the assignment screen, but we just put our message in here. If we want to, we can assign a topic or attach a file, but I think this is particularly good for when you're not going to be in the lesson. And again, you can also schedule announcements, but I'm just going to choose Post. And there you can see the announcement in my Classroom stream. Now in the next webinar, we'll cover the students completing the work and the teacher collecting it. And we'll be using Read and Write for Google Chrome to help us complete the work in that session. So we're going to get it installed now so that everything's ready to go for the next webinar. Now to install it, we need to visit the Chrome Web Store. So we're going to open a new tab by clicking the button at the top of the screen and then search in Google for Chrome Web Store. And then we just choose the first link that appears. The Chrome Web Store has thousands of apps and extensions for Google Chrome, but we're going to search for Read and Write. and we're looking for the read and write for Google Chrome extension in the second half of the page. A Google Chrome extension is something that adds functionality to a page you visit or a website that you use, whereas a Chrome app tends to be a website in its own right. So once you've found the read and write for Google Chrome extension, you need to click the blue Add to Chrome button on the right-hand side of the page. When you do that, you'll get a prompt asking if you really do want to add it, so we click Add Extension. And we'll get a second prompt to tell us that it's been added successfully. Once you've done that, we need to jump back into the document we created earlier. So click back on the Worksheet tab in the top of the screen. And now we need to refresh the page. And we do that by clicking the round arrow button on the left-hand side. Now you might have noticed that the read and write for Google Chrome icon has appeared at the top of the screen. And if you click on that, because it's the first time we've used it, you're going to get a prompt to allow some permissions. So you can review those, then scroll down and click Allow. And if you click the button to open the toolbar again, it will pop out and give you a second prompt asking you to review some permissions. And again, click the button, choose Allow. And once you've got the page saying it's been successful, you can simply close that tab. So Read and Write for Google Chrome is completely free for teachers. That means teachers can always get every single feature on this toolbar, and there's a link at the end of this webinar so that you can sign up for yourself. Now, Read and Write for Google Chrome is great for literacy, but actually I think it's great for all students to keep organized and helps them take control of their own learning, especially when visiting pages all around the web, as well as using Google Docs or Slides. One of the key features in Read and Write for Google Chrome is text-to-speech. So I just want to give you a quick taste of that now before we dive into the other features in the next webinar. So I'm just going to move my cursor over to the beginning of the first sentence of the poem, and then I move up to the toolbar and simply click the play button.
They put me in the oven too. Me a deprived and miserable cake. Feeling the heat, I started to bubble. Watching the others, I knew I was in.
So that's just one of the many features in Read and Write for Google Chrome, and we'll explore more of them as we complete this worksheet in the next session. So just to recap, we've covered a lot in under 15 minutes today. First, you created a class in Google Classroom. Then you created a worksheet in Google Docs before adding some students to the class. Then we set that worksheet that you created as an assignment and also tried posting an announcement in Classroom 2. Finally, we installed Read and Write for Google Chrome, and you had a quick demo of the text-to-speech feature. Join me next week to see how the students would complete the work with the help of Read and Write for Google Chrome, and also to see how the teacher, that's you, will collect and assess the work as well. I hope you found today's session informative, and don't forget, I will be checking the comments, so if you have any questions, just pop them below the video. Otherwise, I'll see you next time.